In the mid-90s, the ZIP drives were on the rise. Before the advent of CDR and CD rewritables, the ZIP was the way of transporting large amounts of data on the go, with the first generation bringing 100 megabytes, the equivalent of around 73.5-inch 1.44 megabyte floppy disks. I must admit, the picture you saw before was taken after I gave one of the drives a repair. As you can see here, the plastic shield was loose. So I jiggled around with the drive to crack it open, which I eventually could manage to do. With the top cover laying in front of me, I could then glue the acrylic shield back into position using a 2-component plastics glue, which dries within seconds. I got both these drives already in summer 2021, and to this day I had never tested them yet. I started with the repaired one, hoping it would still work. But first I had to install the Iomega wear onto my laptop, which one reboot later gave me a new drive letter E for the ZIP drive. Every so often I get disks and drives into my possession, which to no surprise still holds any random data. It's a question of honors to just leave it alone and not look at it, and simply wipe the disks clean. But here, for demonstration purposes, we have the 50sways.exe file, which is actually a factory pre-installed file found on all pristine ZIP disks. The demo here showcases some ideas how to use ZIP disks, like for backups, storing your data, or even installing your applications onto it.
Would this actually perform when running through a parallel port connection?
Not really, but ZIP drives also existed with IDE and SCSI interfaces, where it surely would deliver ample of throughput. I never tested it though, so far. Anyway, I'd then be formatting the ZIP disk. Iomega registered their own formatting tool to the Windows Explorer context menu. But of course, the standard Windows formatting utility and also the DOS format command would work likewise.
What's this clicking noise?
That's the sure indication of a defective ZIP disk. Not unexpected when dealing with historic disk media. I did also have a bunch of ZIP250s and also two ZIP250 drives. And thankfully, they worked as well, so I could also wipe the ZIP250s. Now, what would I do with these ZIP drives, you ask? Well, I had this idea for building an universal copy station, not only for creating the various disk floppy media, but I could also use it to load the ZIP disks as well. For vintage systems like these, transferring bigger amounts of data kind of works via serial parallel connections, but in some situations it's way easier to just hook a ZIP drive via the parallel port instead. And by the way, this box here, holding 4 ZIP250s, sold as the Gigapack for a stunning price of 155 Swiss francs back in 1998. And I even have this single disc with still the price label there of 38 Swiss francs and 60 rappen. I'm the vintage collector, and this was my short advent time story for today. Thanks for watching, and see you again tomorrow. If you check out this channel's community tab, you'll find some polls on potential upcoming videos. You're very welcome to upvote on upcoming topics or drop in new ones you'd like me to chase down.